I was amazed to see the people from different countries. I saw a lot of Indian, I saw a lot of Asian, I saw a lot of Caucasian, but I don't know which. I want to know these people and want to know their culture, what it would be like.
I never really lived before. I lived through my parents, not for myself, until I came here.
Actually, I didn't know. I didn't know about Hawaii. Nobody knew, you know, where Hawaii was, or nobody heard about Hawaii before. Obviously, there are a lot of people, they don't know about most of the states or most of the names that a lot of states have here in America.
For as long as I can remember, I wanted to feel that I was needed, and I wanted to be in a situation where I could contribute to people's lives and know that I was contributing something that was useful and that was needed and that would help them.
I need the resources of the center because the library is full of people's ideas and people's experiences in the form of a book. And every person, in a sense, is a book, but as a living book. So I need people. I need the living books of people.
East-West Center, a project of the United States government in cooperation with the University of Hawaii. Center for Cultural and Technical Interchange between East and West, founded 1960. A name, a date, a statement of sponsorship, and an attempt at an explanatory phrase. All of it taken together tells you what it's called and who put it here. But it's no more than a name on a mailbox. It doesn't tell you how it works. The buildings tell you what it looks like. Good as they are, praised and given prizes, they cannot tell you what happens here. The East-West Center is a concept, an idea put into practice, a continuing experiment. As such, its vitality, its energy, its drive can only be as good as the energies and curiosities of the men and women who populate it. They are students and practitioners, teachers and technicians, and they come here from 30 countries for master's degrees and PhDs to learn animal husbandry and meteorology, and to argue about the single right way to cook rice. They are surprising. They are vulnerable. They are improvisatory. They are individuals. Chow Tan Thuy, Vietnamese, 24 years old, Saigon born and educated, profession, pharmacist. Her aim at the center, a master's degree in pharmacology.
I was very, very much frightened when I first came, but of course I never tried to show it because I knew there would be a weakness to show it, might be stupid. Sometimes I feel a certain confusion. I don't know how I should act, how I should react. Therefore, the best way for me to do is just to act according to the situation. Sometimes the Oriental way, sometimes the Occidental way, and I react just like a woman.
There are three major divisions making up the East-West Center. Chow Tan Twi is part of that section called ISI, the Institute for Student Interchange, as are most of the people in this room. In the main, these are degree candidates, whether they have come here for their doctorate, their master's, or very occasionally, their undergraduate degree. Some of them know precisely what they want. Others know in a general way, and others still will find their direction right here. Twi belongs to the first category.
I used to be very ambitious. I wanted to do something. I'm a pharmacist, but I don't like to stand at the corner of the counter counting pills and counting the money and counting the bills. I don't like to become a businesswoman. So I had the ambition to become a teacher at the university, to do some research. I don't have the ambition of becoming the Madame Curie or a Nobel Prizer. However, I want to do something.
What happened, Mohammed? Doesn't seem to work.
What are the guests? Vaccine.
Oh, that's right. Too much. I think it's okay now.
Chow Tan Twi is engaged in directed research on the interaction between plant pigments called flavonoids and amino acid combinations known as spasmogenic polypeptides. Twi's personal aims are almost as specific as her research project. But there is room at the center for individuals whose goals are less than totally defined. Mabel Cecilia Burks, American, 27 years old, native of Natchitoches, Louisiana. Graduate of Grambling College, 2 years Peace Corps Philippines, 4 years teaching English, Ponape District, United States Trust Territory, Micronesia.
My mother was a teacher. I was influenced by many of the comments that were made by former students of hers. And I can remember them constantly saying, if it hadn't been for her, where they may have been or may not have been. And they felt that she was doing something that was worthwhile. And then my mother died when I was very young, and I think I remembered this. And I wanted to be useful when I grew up. I don't really feel that I have a home, but when I think of going back to a place, I think of going back to Micronesia. When I think in terms of people, I think of a little place in Texas. I have 6 nieces and nephews there, and I feel very warm toward them. I'm not sure that I've found myself yet. And the more people I meet, the more different kinds of people. I'm no longer concerned just with a certain kind of people, but I'm concerned with people.
Roughly speaking, for every American who comes to the East-West Center as a member of ISI, there are 2 Asians. They come from Singapore, from Malaysia, from Thailand, Laos, Hong Kong, and Taiwan, from nearly everywhere west of Honolulu. Some grantees clearly come from the East, some from the West, but a few resist classification entirely. Fazil Nazar, Afghan, 23 years old, born and raised in Kabul, Afghanistan. Profession, not yet determined. His aim at the East-West Center, a bachelor's degree. As an Afghan, he represents one of the few countries from which grantees are sought for undergraduate study.
All I knew about the rest of the world outside Afghanistan was through school and through books that I read while I was in Afghanistan. And also sometimes one of the premises. American classes are quite different from my own educational background. Must talk about the same thing. When I came to America, it was very hard to adjust at the beginning. But since that was the only alternative I had, I tried to adjust. And after a while, I got used to the system. it is easier than it was before.
Each center grantee who enters the Institute for Student Interchange is assigned a host family, which is one of the primary functions of an auxiliary group called the Friends of the East-West Center. For the grantee, it's a shortcut into household familiarity with American life in the Honolulu community. For the members of the host families, it can be a kind of pickup extension course in international living.
Music and Afghan life is a very important factor. I remember those times that I used to pray with my family. I used to go to mosque. This kind of made me somehow homesick.
Every Friday afternoon at 1:30 on an open lounge of the ninth floor of Hale Manoa, the men's dormitory of the center, there is heard a call which is universal through the Islamic world. It is the azan, the timeless Muslim call to prayer. The priest in this case is the Afghan, Abdul Wasay Hakiki. Hakiki's prayers, like the azan, are in Arabic. They are ritually a part of every Muslim's life. But his sermon is in English. It is the only language that could possibly work. There are Muslims here from India, from Pakistan, from Ceylon, from Malaysia, from Indonesia, from the Sudan, from Kenya, from Jordan, and of course, from Afghanistan. A Muslim prayer meeting with Diamond Head as a background isn't an anachronism. Not here. It is an adaptation. At the center, adaptation has reached the level of an art. A dining room serving people from more than 30 countries could be a culinary battleground. What marks perfection in Thailand is incendiary in Australia. What seems ideal in Nepal can be dull in Indonesia. So grantees approach a table of condiments like a surgical team advancing on an operating table. Adaptation, lunch line level. Adaptation, postal subdivision. More formal, but aimed in the same pragmatic direction, are the Asia-America seminars. This one is on the topic of rural and urban development. In charge is a representative of the East-West Center's second major division, the Institute for Advanced Projects. Dr. William V. Vitarelli, American, 58 years old, born in New York City, educated at Columbia University. Position, High Commissioner's Representative, Trust Territory of the Pacific Islands, Micronesia. Senior Specialist at the East-West Center. His aim at the center? Time to write one book on community development and another on tropical architecture.
When I first got into community development work and thought about going overseas, I wanted to have an opportunity to participate in helping people come into the 20th century. I wanted to be part of it. An office, a classroom is like your signature. Your personality comes out in how you work. Some people like a clean desk and a calendar and a few pieces of paper, and their approach to writing is that way. I'm not that way. I have to see everything at once, so my office does look messy. I move around a lot. But that's the way I work. The beauty of the East-West Center is that it is flexible. It doesn't matter what field you come from, so long as you have a passion for something. Everybody's willing to listen.
College professors, government administrators, artists, and scientists. They come here for 1 year from any of 30 countries. They are senior specialists, and they bring to the center the experience they have gained over long years of work in the field or in concentrated academic careers. Here they work on research projects, they consult, they write, and they publish.
We are all more or less interested in things beyond our little academic field, and that's what's so vital and so interesting. There are others here who have what you would call avocations. Mine happens to be architecture and building. Building a house is like painting a picture. It's like writing a letter. It's something you do when you have a family and you want a roof over your head. Instead of renting a house, it's more logical, in my book, the way I do things, to build one. My family likes the idea. First of all, a lot of us. Building a house was practical. It's a creative act, has an emotional appeal. It's just a lot of fun.
They come here bringing with them whatever it is that makes them tick, whatever makes them different. Time they are here, they share what they have, throwing it into the mutual experience which is the center. They change in ways you can see, or they do not. They write their book, conduct their research, earn their degree, acquire their advanced skill, and then they go. They go back to their old lives, or they do not. Sometimes what they have learned can be enough to change the lives of the people to whom they return. Sirawat Sarovan, Thai, 29 years old, educated at Thailand's Kasetsart University. Profession, livestock breeding and management. His aim at the center, a master's degree in animal science.
We have here Herford steer number 7037.
I think right now the world's in confusion because of, I think, lack of understanding, and we left some people behind. There are so many people who are poor, and most of the people who are poor are in agriculture. That's why I'm going to agriculture. I remember when I was a small child, most of my friends were children of the farmers. I've played with them. I've gone to the life with them, going out to the rice field, drive the cattle, or board the buffalo into the highland to raise them, going down to the rice field to harvest the rice with them. It was fun at the time, but after I grew up, it's no fun at all. It was a hardship. I want to see them have a better life than that. The young generation to have a better life.
Sirawat Sarovan is part of the East-West Center's third and final major section, the ITI, Institute for Technical Interchange. Through the ITI, key personnel are trained for work in developing areas. Areas which, for one reason or another, are short in specific skills and specialties. Sirawat Sarovan's work is in animal breeding. He has spent 4 years with his country's Department of Livestock.
If I had time and money, I would like to go every place in the world to see what's the difference of the people and why they behave like that. So this understanding will extend to my people and to the people I know. Over here, I speak a lot so that they can know me, what my idea is, because they have had much Thai people over here. So I have to represent one sample of the Thai so that the people can evaluate what's the Thai way. I have to give the idea so that this will represent an idea of a Thai one in 32 million.
मुझे तुम्हारे पर पूरा भरोसा है मैं जब भी कभी ऐसा मौका आता है
असंदे मस किनो गकुए काई देशिता बकवा योगी या उताया दोवा नि
यो द छिन सन जाय बु पा मे चाय शाओ यी रेन जाय वा गन यो
Noticed a greater change in the average Asian student than in the average American student because the Asian student has to change his way of thinking to adjust himself to the new life that he has at the center. But when this same Asian student goes home later on, there will be another change, and this time it will be a very difficult change for him. In my case, when I go home, I shall be submitted to the same change, but I believe that my parents will be understanding enough to let me keep a few things I have learned at the East West Center, to save those few things.
In Louisiana, I went to school and worked and played with people from the same kind of background. And there was very little to learn from these acquaintances, even when they were very close. I find that even casual acquaintances at the center probably teach more coming from different backgrounds than a very close associations with people from the same background. It's like the experience at the center will be similar to fertilizing a plant. It won't make the plant, but it'll certainly make it grow.
It's good for the African students to live in America and learn the American way of life. And also, it is good for American students and for American people to know how Afghans live and what their culture is. And this is the opportunity that East West Center has provided for them.
When I first came to the center and saw 100 or so of my Micronesian friends, I didn't realize that these youngsters, some of them, who would be able to adjust so readily. It has given me a great deal of satisfaction. When people return to their own culture after being away, they obviously go back with new concepts, new ideas, new skills.
They come from many places and for many reasons. These three young women and this man have come great distances to learn new techniques in creating a sterile field in an operating room. They are all nurses. For the nurses, the duration of the grant is 9 months. They come, they learn, and they leave. There is an Asian saying, "We are born to meet and part."
The first time I came over here, it bothered me. Because I don't know what to act. I lack of my confidence. Sounds like I did wrong all the time. I think I get more confidence over here and I can speak out more and try to find out the best possibility to do. After I finish the school from the United States, I'll go back to Thailand and work in the livestock department. I'll do my best. I'll work for the people.
Institute for Student Interchange, 300 grants a year. Institute for Technical Interchange, 350 scholarships and grants annually. Institute of Advanced Projects, 40 senior specialists come here every year. For every arrival, there is a departure.
There's one thing which I do not like very much, is to see your friends off. I love to greet other people, but it's too sad to go to the airport to say goodbye to those people whom you have known for a while and whom you might not be able to see again. So I really hate that. I really hate those departures. Since I've been to the center, I have seen so many, many people off already. And every time you give them a name, every time you say goodbye, I shall see you in your own country. Take care. And they just disappear from your life like that.
I'm not certain where the direction in my life should be. I may go back to the Trust Territory and work. I may work in North Carolina or Louisiana or someplace like that on an Indian reservation. I may go to Samoa and work in education and television, which I just haven't made up my mind yet. And these are just possibilities. I'm certain that I will teach again. That's what I want to do. The only uncertainty is where.
It is impossible to leave people alone. People from the time of the caveman to the present day have been interrelating, sharing. And no matter where one lives, another man comes and relates to him. You cannot leave him alone. Every man is different for having known another man.
My life is different now from what it was before. I got to know more people and the way they react. This is the reason I like this community that we have at the center, where people really understand each other. They don't feel that they're different.
The world was separated by the distance, or by the sea, or by the mountain. So we have hardly communicated. Someday we might bring the world into one. To know each other well enough, it takes time. I would like to see this world in peace. I think that's a possibility. And maybe we can get together sometimes.
When I go home, when I read the newspapers, and if something happens in other countries, in Thailand or in Indonesia, then I would say, oh, I had some Thai friends at the center. What will happen to those Thai friends now? Or what would happen to those Indonesian people which I knew at the center?
East West Center, a project of the United States government in cooperation with the University of Hawaii. Center for Cultural and Technical Interchange between East and West. Founded 1960. In a month, a year, 2 years, everyone here will have gone, returned to the lives from which they came. Something of this place will have gone with them. But there is more, waiting for those who come after.
One for